So in the Scottie Road area, was that a tough area, Gordon, in those days?
Yes, it was both. It was both tough and it was very human.
Yeah.
Very compassionate. You know, there's passions either side. I mean, yeah. They talk about, say, the football team is not a pastime. It's like a religion in Liverpool because the passions are there. But it was tough. But I was only 19 when I first put a helmet on and walked down Scotland Road. And I'm trying to hold myself up to my full height. At that time, I probably weighed about 10 stone, trying to grow a moustache. Trying to look important. I went walking down the road and I can still see them so vivid, the two women that walked past me, and I'm trying to look very proud and important that they walked past. This woman said to the other, "Oh, God love him," she said. "He shouldn't be out on his own, that lad." That's going on there. And of course the shops were, they're all lovely little shops, yeah. There in Great Homer Street that ran parallel.
It was a little world on its own, wasn't it? A bit like the Bowery, the Bowery Boy films.
It was a real community. And again, those who were the scallywags, they were known. All the rest were people who never bothered with the front door key. Mm. They never locked it, never dreamed of locking the doors because they knew the pockets of the bad. But all the others, and they give you anything, coming officer and whatever. Mm-hmm. And the thing was, they'd have a bottle of Guinness in the house, or and sometimes pensioners all put. You knew they only have one. Here, officer, have a drink. No, it's all right. You're having a drink, and you could not say no. Yeah. They would be totally mortified and offended if you didn't say yeah.
Yeah, well, it wasn't a rich area, was it? There must be lots of unemployment and.
There was, but the hearts were far bigger than whatever their pockets were. And that was evident by if you ever went to the house, and some of them really were poor, but you were made to feel welcome, and they would share, and they would not see anybody go short. I know colleagues of mine who have, off their own bat, would have taken, I mean, we went on good money, but if they got a little food parcel together, they knew somebody, old lady on the street, it's just a case of here, say nothing, you know. Mm. So we used to get kids a lot used to come into Rose Hill, knocking on the window, looking for comics, because we used to bring stuff in. Or sometimes you knew somebody on the beat that where if you'd been through your police shirt and there was still a bit of life left into it, it was a case of say nothing. Yeah. But yeah, it was there was not a lot of money around there at all, but there was always a smile. There was always the bright side of life with the people. And it was just a delight to work.